Sebastian Vettel Martinez, MMAnytt here with Thiago Alves, who faces off with Alexey Kunchenko. So we're at a pretty historic event, first UFC event in Russia. I think a lot of people expected it to happen sooner on account of how many, you know, talented fighters there are from here. How do you feel about being part of history?
I feel super excited, man. You know, I love Russia. You know, I have a lot of Russian friends in the gym. You know, it's a great a fighting country. So I'm excited to be here and put it on a show for everybody.
And when you were offered Alexey Kunchenko, was there any sort of hesitation about it or stuff like that? Because it's kind of a, not necessarily the best matchup because he's a debutant, but he's a very skilled fighter. So, you know, you have a lot to lose with him.
No, I got nothing to lose. You know, I've been kicking ass at this, you know, organization for over 13 years now. Now he's the undefeated, and he's the one, you know, coming into this new organization, fighting on his hometown. So I think all the pressure's on him, you know. But regardless, I am, you know, prepared for a title shot. You know, that's how I train. I don't want to live in a judge's hands, you know. I know I'm fighting on his country, so I want to make sure I get out of here with a submission or a knockout victory.
And considering that you've been in the UFC for so long, obviously you have so much top-tier, you know, experience against GSP and, you know, Carlos Condit, the likes of many of the best in the world. And you're also, like you said, you know, you've been here for a while. It's his first fight, and there's a lot of pressure with that. Do you feel that sort of octagon experience will be a big factor in this fight?
Definitely, you know, it definitely will be something that's going to play in my factor, you know. Again, everything on the table for him, you know. I'm here as a dark horse, you know, but I'm a motherfucker, man. I'm prepared, you know. He's going to see a fucking very well-training pit bull in front of him, and I'm going to come in there to take his hat off.
Well, excellent. I mean, I know that you got a lot of fans around the world, one of them standing behind the camera as well, and you know, you've had some ups and downs recently, some tough, you know, you tried yourself out at lightweight, and it seemed like, you know, you were maybe sort of trying out some new stuff. Where do you feel about where you are in your career, like, right now, and where you are in, you know, in terms of shape and weight class and all that?
I feel perfect, you know. Lightweight is something, a vision that I had, you know, and I'm the type of guy that I see something, I'm going to try to make it happen. And unfortunately, it didn't happen. I think it was for the best, you know, because it was a horrible week, you know, for me. But I feel great, man. This is the best Thiago Alves, the best pit bull, you know, ever. You know, I'm mature. I got a ton of experience. And I have nothing else holding me back, you know. I feel ready. I feel prepared, you know, and everything's going to come together on Saturday night. You guys in for a treat.
Well, we're definitely hoping for it. You said that there's nothing else holding you back now. What do you feel was holding you back before?
You know, like before, when I was a little younger, you know, it was all about career, and trying to make it happen. And I did make it happen. I'm able to, you know, live a beautiful, blessed life, you know, but my personal life wasn't a part. You know, so one side was great, the other side wasn't. So now everything's finally come together. That doesn't mean because you make a change, things are going to happen right away. You know, there is a time, a try and error period, you know. And I think I've been through all the bad things, you know, everything that I need to go through. I learned from it, and I'm ready, man. I'm ready to fucking, you know, be the best I can be.
So facing a guy who's new to the UFC, sometimes it can be a little bit hard finding footage and stuff, but this guy, he's very well established on the European scene. You know, sizing up him against you, where do you see some holes in his game, and where do you feel that you're stronger?
You know, he's well-rounded. He's a good fighter, but again, you know, at this level that I'm competing, he's just another guy. You know, and that's the reality of it. So I don't see anything special. You know, I think I'm better everywhere, and I'm going to show it.
And you're coming in here off of a tough loss. Have you had a chance to sort of look back at it to see, like, what you felt went wrong and what you could have done better?
I was just trying to make the best out of a shitty situation, you know. I was supposed to fight Mike Perry in September. Didn't happen because of the hurricane. And then I'm scheduled to fight Zach Cummins in January, you know. And that doesn't happen either because he gets hurt, you know, a day before. And then, like, 4 weeks or 3 weeks after, they reschedule to a different guy that is completely different style, completely different size, you know. So we're just trying to navigate, you know, through this storm, you know, the best way we could. I didn't have enough time to prepare, you know. And the guy that I fought was very good, you know, had a lot of length on me, you know, a lot of reach. So, you know, unfortunately, I got caught in the first round. I was able to come back, you know, and finish on top. Second round, I was winning until I got caught with that big knee, you know. And that's MMA, man. It's unforgiving, you know. Sometimes you put everything online, you get a reward. Sometimes you don't. But I learned a lot about myself. I know I'm a motherfucker, man. Even if my body gives up, my mind is going to be there. If my mind gives up, my body is going to be there. You really have to put me away to stop me, you know? So knowing that, it gives me a lot of comfort to go out there and fucking put everything on the line again.
Well, I mean, we've seen that time and time again, Pitbull, ride or die. You've had so many great performances, you know, in the octagon. And I'm sure, you know, you could make yourself and make your own top five list or something like that. But, you know, if you had to choose one performance where you feel that you're most proud of, where you feel you truly showed the real Pitbull, what performance would that be?
There are a few, you know. I think I think when I fought Cote, you know, I was coming off two losses, you know, I lost to Carlos Condit, and then didn't work out against, you know, Jim Miller, trying to make weight and everything. So I had my back against the wall, you know, that's one of them. When I fought Jordan Mayne, you know, it was another one. And then you go Matt Hughes, Karchak, you know, Carter Parisian, you know. When I fought Carter Parisian, I was scared to death, you know, because at that time he was killing everybody.
It was the heat.
Yeah, he was the heat, definitely. So, you know, there was a lot of performance, but I don't dwell on the past, you know. I think that guy that did those things, you know, he was good for that time and period, you know. This is a whole different animal right now, you know, and I'm ready to put him out there and unleash the Pitbull.
Well, I can't possibly end it any better than that. Unleash for Pitbull. Fans at home, be sure to keep a lookout for this fire of a fight between Thiago Alves and Alexey Kunchenko. Thiago, very nice meeting you. Thank you. Good luck in the fight.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate it.